Okay, so my father is a navigator, and when I was a little boy, he used to go 6 months sailing around the globe, and his 6 months he was staying with me back home, telling me stories about the places he visited, about the things he saw. Always looking forward for his comebacks, this opened up new worlds for me. I felt that this created a desire that to discover and to see new place every time. This turned out to be very handy, because even though I was growing under the communism regime, from that moment, with his stories in my mind grew, understanding that there are no boundaries, that you can simply go to Cape Town or to other places just by spinning the globe. Looking backward, I think that was the moment when I started to realize that there are no boundaries and that everything is related to self-confidence. Today, I want to share with you four elements that will help you boost your self-confidence. The first one are routines. So, you know probably that there are good routines and bad routines. For me, the morning coffee, it's a good routine. Wherever I am, whatever I'm doing, I find time for my morning coffee. That works as an anchor for me, keeping me on a safe track. But let's talk about the other routines. Have you ever noticed your friends, your group of friends, talking about old stories or stories about bad things happening to them? Have you ever wondered why is this happening? Well, we woke up in the morning, go to work, drink our coffee maybe, go to work. We meet our colleagues, go into meetings, get back from work, and watch some Netflix and chill. Well, this is happening over and over again for multiple days in a row. When was the last time you did something for the first time? When something bad happens to you, actually it creates a moment that breaks that routine, a moment that you'll be able to remember further on. But what do you think about creating your own memories? In 2006, while working for a multinational company and being a student in the same time, I decided to go to California, United States, in a work and travel program. I was in a group of seven, and everything was new to me. We got a car, an old car, and we traveled with it the West Coast. The car being old got us into all kinds of situations that we had to manage somehow and get the car back on the road. But in the same time, that showed us that we can do it, that nothing will happen to us. Small things happened, and in 2012, I found myself talking with my friends about the same stories that the stories, the summer we had in 2006. So in those 6 years, nothing major happened. And we are still talking about our summer, that was a magical one, in 2006. But come on, 6 years passed. Since that moment, it was clear that it would not be a singular adventure. And that was the moment when I started researching things in order to do something the next round. All of a sudden, everything was clear. I wanted to gather people with similar interests and make things happen together. This is how the idea, the community of Today You Can Do Anything was born. If you see our community, read about our stories, and if you ask yourself, can I? That's it. Our mission is fulfilled. In 2012, I've signed up for the Mongo Rally. My friends called me crazy. They said that I can't do it, that is too dangerous, and that I should have done other things. What is Mongo Rally? In Mongo Rally, you just have to get a small car. You know that car that usually your grandparents are driving to the marketplace and back, and drive it to the end of the world. We took a Peugeot 206 and we took it to Ulan Bator, Mongolia. We drove 19,000 kilometers in total, and we crossed countries and cities I've learned about from history books. Once I went back home to my daily job, I was talking to my colleagues, went in the same meetings with the same agenda, and talking to them, I realized that nothing happened. After all, for them, there were only 2 months. But for me, there were 86,000 minutes of living memories. Once I went back to Romania, people asked me, what was the biggest lesson you've learned out of this? Well, I thought about, and for a long period of time, I was telling stories about moments when our car went into flames in Mongolia, or when soldiers with AK-47 stopped us and asked for documents or whatever else. But in reality, what I've got out of this was the fact that I found myself really comfortable and really trustworthy when I was doing things out of the ordinary, when I was breaking the routines. The next thing I want to talk about are unexpected things. So we talked about routines and bad things happening to you. When something unexpected is happening to you, it's your choice if you want to see the half full of the glass or the empty one. I was in Peru in 2014, driving a motor taxi. A motor taxi is a vehicle that locals are using inside the cities. I was driving it for 3,000 kilometers from north of Peru to south of it in Machu Picchu. We had multiple breakdowns and problems along the way, but at some moment, it happened that when we are at more than 4,000 meters, our motor taxi couldn't start and we couldn't make it back, take it back on the road. We are really tired. It was cold because the altitude was high. We weren't used to it. And somebody stopped at some point, got us in a truck. He was transporting pineapples, but he managed to squeeze our motor taxi in. And even though it was really cold outside and we are really tired, we just had massive fun around that moment. March 2018, that's last year in March, we were in Siberia driving a sidecar. It was old, it was from 87, and again, it was with a lot of mechanical problem along the way. We were on the Baikal Lake, that's the deepest lake in the world, on ice, at minus 35 degrees. The thing is that the lake being so big, the ice cracks, and you can see, hear and see the cracks that are happening on the ice. Usually, there are two things that could happen with the ice. The ice cracks, and the fresh water will come beneath the ice. And every year, the statistics show that 40 vehicles are going under the ice. But we managed to not to do that. The second thing was that they form an ice wall. Once the ice wall is formed, you have to smash it or to just find another way, like in a labyrinth, in a maze, trying to find your way through the lake. The weather on the lake, it changes rapidly. And you have portions, let's say, with minus 25 degrees and with minus 35 in a couple of minutes. And it's really hard to accommodate your clothes in order to fit that. But during the night, the show was started. Once we were camping on the lake and everybody was in their tents, it was really quiet. And all of a sudden, you can hear the cracks in the ice. That's beneath our tents. Imagine that you are in a forest, the winds blow really rapidly, and you can see the branches are cracking. But again, they are under you. And you have the deepest lake in the world underneath. Well, in those moments, you can think about that, the sound, as being something that is threatening you, or as being the sound of a magical antique instrument that you can witness the show of. The next thing I'm going to talk about are your fears. In my opinion, the difference between fears and things you don't like is really, really thin. Usually, you say that you don't like a certain activity, you don't like to do something, but the reality might be that you are afraid of it. In childhood, while my friends were climbing all kinds of tall buildings, I've tried to do that, but I realized that I don't like it. Or at least that was the thing that I've told myself at that moment. Later on, I discovered that I had one of my biggest fears was acrophobia. That's an extreme or irrational fear of heights. At some point, I decided that I must work with it. So when I was at the seventh floor of an apartment building, I just went over the balcony, looking down for 1 second the first day because I was shivering, coming back the next day, and so on and so forth. I can say that in 2 or 3 years, I was able to look for a couple of minutes over the balcony. When I was staying over the time, I kept exposing myself to such situations, like here when I was in Grand Canyon over the edge of a cliff, and that helped me to grow my self-confidence. The ultimate challenge for me was skydiving. It's very important to work with your fears, because once you understand what is happening with your mind and your body, you'll be able to embrace them and you'll be able to control, let's say, your fears. The fourth thing I'm going to talk about and I'm willing to share with you are your limits and the fact that you should challenge them. As you probably noticed, so far I've done all kinds of adventures, but none of them involved the water. When I was in California, I've told you that my father was a navigator, and I called him, telling him that I'm in the only ocean that he didn't cross. I was in the only ocean that was missing from my bedtime stories, let's say. And I've called him and I told him about that. And since that moment, I found California, which I think that it's a great place on this earth, and the Pacific Ocean to have something really powerful, to transmit to me really, something really powerful. Therefore, I felt that the next adventure should happen over there. So I was looking for different adventures. This is the biggest Viking ship built in modern times. And in 2015, they were looking for somebody in their crew. I applied, I've talked to them, but it seems that there were too many people involved already. And we Romanian, with our history in navigation not being that great, I didn't get chosen for that. But I started researching more and more, and I found another one. This is in Zanzibar. It's a traditional boat built out of mango, and I have this still on my list. But at some moment, in 2016, I've met Alex, and he had some similar interest as mine. We are involved in a project to row over the Atlantic. Even though we didn't went that far with this project, we said that we have to do it and that the Pacific will have to be our ocean to row. So, since last month in June, we got the rowing boat on the Black Sea. So, we have the only rowing boat on the Black Sea, and we started training, and we are gathering people around that want to try something new, that they want to test their limits. And the plan is to cross the Black Sea next year in less than 8 days, and also to row over the Pacific. So these are four elements that you can use in your daily life in order to boost your self-confidence. When I was in Ulan Bator, Mongolia, I've met someone traveling the world in a school bus. I'm on that school bus, and the owner was sitting next to me. On the front bumper of the school bus, there is a quote: "One day, your life will flash before your eyes. Make sure it's worth watching." Therefore, don't forget that today you can do anything, and the universe is giving you feedback right at this moment. Just take it. Thank you.